In today's tutorial, you'll learn two ways to create and use custom texture brushes. You are watching TNT Tutorials? Let's move on! You don't need a tablet to use texture brushes in Illustrator. I'll show you all possible variations, so check them out. Take any shape and duplicate it as many times as you want, or pick the pencil tool and create a noise like this. Open Brushes panel and click here to add a new brush. Choose Scatter Brush, skip all settings for now and click OK. Press B to use the brush tool. Create a stroke and double-click on your scatter brush in the Brushes panel. First of all, adjust spacing. As you can see, I have everything fixed here, and only scatter and rotation are random. You can adjust the same because these values are really balanced well. Size and rotation are totally up to you. In rotation, play with both sliders to get nice randomness without obvious repeats. Click OK and apply to strokes. You can edit your brush strokes with the direct selection tool, which is very handy. If you have too many points, go to Object, Path, Simplify, and remove all unneeded points. Now you can easily play with texture brush with the direct selection tool. Here's option where you don't need the brush tool at all. You can create a path with the pen tool and apply your scatter brush to this path. Switch to the direct selection tool, move it as you want, use the selection tool to duplicate it, and repeat the same. Second way to create a texture brush is to use the Symbol Sprayer tool. Click on Window and select Symbols. Pick Noise and click here to add a new symbol. Let's simply change name here and click OK. Press Shift plus S to pick the Sprayer tool and press Enter to open options. It's better to keep these values the same, and that's all you need to know here. Click OK and use right or left brackets on your keyboard to adjust spray size. Draw something like this. You can even use a mouse. After you'll have one spraying, you can hold Ctrl or Command, click somewhere to deselect it, and create another one. Let's hold Ctrl or Command and click on this spraying to select it. Hold Shift and you'll be able to increase density like this. Hold Alt or Option key and click to decrease density. Release all buttons on your keyboard and use only left mouse button to spray in this selection again. After you'll finish, click here to break link to symbol. You have all this noise as outlines and you can change stroke width and change color. Or you can simply click on Object, Path and select Outline Stroke to convert strokes to objects. When you're creating a texture for a sprayer, it's better to adjust texture size before you'll add it to symbols. You don't need to think about the color at all. Use black spraying, click on Properties, Opacity, and choose Soft Light. In the same time, you can change color of your texture manually. It's totally up to you. There's two ways to apply textures to shapes: clipping mask and draw inside mode. With clipping mask, create a texture first, then copy needed object to the top, select copy and a texture, right click, make clipping mask. To use the draw inside mode, select needed shape, click on this icon, pick sprayer tool or pen tool or brush tool and apply texture. If you learned something new from this tutorial, drop a comment below. Let me know if everything was clear enough for you and what you liked about this video. If you enjoyed this tutorial, support this channel by clicking on subscribe and what's most important, by clicking on the bell icon to get notifications about newest tutorials from TNT. I'd also appreciate if you'll click thumbs up and we'll share this video. This was TNT Tutorials. See you in next videos!